Hello, this is Parker with Whitetail Gearhead, and this video is on how to make your own HYS strap. Now, I know they have them online for $30, but if you want to make your own and be a DIY guy, then this is how I did mine. Now, here's what you're going to need. You're going to need, for the base part of it, you're going to need this webbing, and you can get it at your hardware store, or you can get it online. But you need 7 feet of this for the base. You're going to need more of the webbing to do the loops. And you also need, from your craft store, some upholstery strength thread, some really strong thread for sewing upholstery. And you'll need a needle about like this, a pretty strong, not one of the small needles, but a strong one that can punch through the webbing fairly easy. You'll need a thimble, you'll need a push pin, you'll need a ruler, and you'll need, let me take this off, one of these binder clips. So that's all you need. Of course, if you have a sewing machine, then you can get this done a lot faster, but this is how to do it if you don't have a sewing machine. So let me show you my measurements and how I got started. So first of all, it's about 6 inches that you leave from here to here on each end. So this is where you start, 6 inches in, and you line your webbing up, and then you start you start sewing. And what I did was I used a double loop back stitch. And you can look that up online. But I did a double loop back stitch. I went down, over, and I went up. So I did 2 rows. And that will be strong enough to hold everything. So you get your first one attached. You get that first one attached. And then what you do is measure from there 2 inches over, and then at 2 inches over you're going to do push your push pin in to your bottom strap just to mark it, and then you'll take your loop strap and you push it upward to make this go up until you make your loop the size of 1 1/4 inches. And all of them you want to be 1 1/4 inches just to be uniform in your loops. And once you get that to 1 1/4 inches, you pinch it, you hold it down, and you take your push pin and you push through both of them. And that holds it in place. Then, once it's held in place, before you start sewing, pretend this loop isn't there, but you'll take your binder clip, and with these two, your webbing level with each other, you clip it so it'll hold it in place so you can sew and it'll keep your webbing in alignment. And so take your push pin off and you start sewing. Of course, you have your clip here. You start sewing and you do it again. And then you continue that process until you get approximately, you're going to get like around 35 loops or so, give or take. So what I did on the other end, I just have a carabiner clip, and this is what I clip into. When I tighten it around the tree or a limb or whatever it goes on, and I snug it to the tree, clip it in, and then I can clip in my gear to the HYS strap. So that's it, and a little pros and cons on it. This, compared to my other tree strap with the hooks, this takes up a little more room in my tethered saddle pouch takes up a little more room, but it's not bad. It still goes underneath my tethered rope, waiting for me when I get up there at the top to settle in. Takes up a little more room. But an advantage that it has is I don't have to move any hooks around or even mess with hooks or hooks that'll get hung up on my other rope. Don't have any of that anymore. So that's the positive of this. Nothing can be tangled up in my pouch and no hooks to adjust. It's just wherever, anywhere. Once it's up on the tree, I'm good to go. I just clip in my gear. No adjusting of anything. So that's it. I'm going hunting Thursday and Friday. Hope I have a good report for you guys. And remember to get out there and hunt. Enjoy God's great creation. And go get you some white-tailed deer this season. And we have this nice cold front. It's coming through and a pre-rut going on, so it's time to get out there and hunt. I'll see you next time.